Great Paul, I'm in your order.
But the nature of the flag, the United States of America, and the Republic which stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mrs. Albright?
Here.
Mrs. Bell?
Here.
Mrs. Beckelman?
Here.
Mr. Gretsch?
Present.
Mrs. Jurek?
Here.
Mrs. Markle?
Here.
Mr. Rittenhouse?
Here.
Mr. Scott here, and Mrs. Thompson?
Here.
All present.
Thank you, Mr. Scott. All right, procedures for public participation. All right. Prepare statements that are read to the board, should have a copy presented to the board president prior to their main address. Comments on agenda items will be made by rising or fixing by threat, stating your name and address and signing on the sheet provided. You will be granted up to 3 minutes to address the board. Your 3 minute time limit will start when you begin to speak. When 3 minutes are over, you will be asked to be seated. Any item that is not on the agenda, as well as agenda items acted upon, comments will be made at the designated section at the end of the agenda. I apologize, your answer was slow. Congratulations, students. We're so incredibly proud. And not at all jealous. that I can't even do a sick leave, I mean, whatever. Thank you so much. Students, we appreciate you being here. We're happy to recognize your accomplishments, but also do not feel as if you have to stay for the entirety of the board.
Good call.
Congrats again, guys. All right, we have a student board representative for this.
This is horrible.
So for the intermediate center, the academic kids are trying to earn their tickets for something to buy a book. Also, got new MyView books online. Extracurricular, they got tic-tac-toe game for outside recess. Cultural, they're making art cards for Valentine's Day. Primary, academically, the kids have been participating in book club. Extracurricular, this new recess equipment is being used. And cultural, the new cotton candy ice cream with lunches.
I gotta say, that was a big hit when I was crazy about the ice cream. For the middle school, academically, the prep for the PSSAs. Actually, there's an assembly for all grades to participate in meeting days that's coming up soon. And for cultural, spirit view for Valentine's Day is taking place. For the high school, we're prepping for EP tests. Extracurricular, we're wrapping up our sports and freezing for a reason is coming up. And for cultural, inclusion spirit view is coming up. And that concludes the student school.
Thank you very much, John.
Thank you.
All right, moving on to finance. That is 281 through 283. Any questions or comments from the board? Any public comment?
Practice for an interview.
high school students know today. So here my students had through the 14th. I believe they had to postpone their open house this afternoon tomorrow night because of the snow. So there was one February 7th, and this was going all right. I'm sure they'll advertise for the influence. And our next meeting is February 28th.
Thompson. Committee on Legislative Action, Mrs. Sackman.
We're actually scheduled to meet tomorrow, but we actually postponed it, so we'll be sending us a commission for the next week.
All right, thank you very much. And this is Marco. Sorry, this is Marco for the guys. And your next meeting is March 20th.
Sorry, Russ, real quick. I just realized the next meeting will be April 9th for us.
Thank you, sir. Any public comment on any of the reports? All right, under enrollment. Monthly head count statistics, any questions from the board? Questions from the board about the monthly alternative education staff totals and monthly education and some alternative education totals. So, any questions from the board on those? Any public comment on any of those action items? All right. Curriculum and Instruction Committee report, Mrs. Thompson.
You met January 22nd. The district gave a summary of student achievement, the Keystone graduation requirement. Grades 3 to 8, the lower tier schools, Keystone's were above your. So, a bunch of statistics on that.
Okay.
it's situated. I put together. So what I put together is just a way. This honestly is equally as beneficial to my own thinking as it is to kind of help lead the discussion. So what we have here is we have Act 56. Specifically, the part of Act 56 I'd like to talk about is the impact that it has to our instructional days and the instructional hours. So the way that public schools have been operating for years has been school districts must hit 180 days of instruction, and you also have to hit 900 hours for elementary, and you have to hit 990 hours of instruction for secondary. Well, in December, that legislation changed, and that word "and" got replaced with "or." So now, school districts have to hit 180 days of instruction, or we can complete our duty as a school district by hitting the instructional hours. So, fun fact about the Vancouver Area School District, we actually exceed, if you break down based on the number of hours, the amount of days by about 7 days worth of instruction, because we provide a little bit more instruction every day than I'll refer to as the minimum expectation set forth by the state. That being said, this legislation does provide flexibility for school districts. If we wanted to adjust the length of this school day, I'm going to say some ridiculous things, please don't, I'm not proposing this. But theoretically, we could go like 4 10-hour days and then have 3-day weekends. Not proposing, but it's something that we could do with this flexibility. It gives us, different opportunities for things that just pop up that we can say, oh, well, you know what, well, maybe we don't need to make up that day. Or when we're designing next year's calendar, maybe we're designing with 180 days, maybe we're not. All right? The immediate impact is actually something a little closer to home, something that may or may not be coming tonight. So one thing, and again, this legislation went into effect in December as soon as it was approved. As soon as it was signed, it was in effect. So things that I want to make sure we're thinking about are we do have opportunities now, because we're over the minimum expectation of instructional hours. It's conceivable, it's possible, it's doable, it's legally allowed for us to say, hey, that snow makeup day, that snow day that we had a month ago, whatever that was, we're not going to make it up because we don't necessarily need to. Then, we also have another potential snow day that may or may not be coming tomorrow, right? These are things that we can take into consideration. And before we just say, yep, cancel it all 7 days, we're going 173 next year, we need to make sure that we keep other things in mind. For example, we have a teacher's contract that has 190 days in the teacher's contract. So what we do is we say, hey, students, you don't need to make up that last day. Our teachers contractually still need to. So we need to keep that in mind. We also have support staff that only get paid when they're working with our students. So when we have a snow day, they don't get paid on that snow day. They get paid on the snow makeup day. So if we eliminate that day, that's essentially a day that they would not get paid. All right? It's never as easy as you want to do. Just if you want to make sure you're clear about that. There also is a perception of, if we don't make up any snow days ever again, up to 7, there is a perception that could be out there that Dan really doesn't care about education. So, like I was talking about earlier, for me it's always moderation, something in the middle, something that we can consider. But that's my personal view. Even though this one hurts my soul a little bit, I'm going to talk about the last one, which is, childcare. We have to recognize the reality of the world that when students aren't in school, families now have to figure out, for the age-appropriate range, like what are they going to do with their children? Right, there's a reality that does live there. So when we think about these things, I think it's important to keep all of those facts in consideration. And I tried to put some bullets in here. So when we're talking about the teacher's contract, yes, right now the teacher's contract does say 190 days. We're also in the middle of contract negotiations. So it's conceivable that we put a different language in there that allows for flexibility within that. Same thing with support staff. We're in the middle of contract negotiations. Maybe there's something that we put in there that says, you know, if we cancel the day, maybe they still receive payment. I don't know. These are ideas at this point. The perception is something that we do need to keep in mind, but the way that we wrap up our school year right now, this school year that was developed, is developed into 4 half days at the end of the year. For me personally, that seems like a little bit much with the half days. Maybe we can do it the last 2 days or half days, and then we just gain back essentially 2 other half days. Maybe that all goes into our equation, so we're not just a straight loss of instructional time. Because, again, my entire life, and life's work, is about providing quality education to open up doors for students in the future. I mean, it does run a little counterintuitive that I should get behind something like this, but I think we do also need to remember the reality of what June looks like. And the quality of learning that is going on some of those days maybe isn't top notch. So I think what we need to do is come to some level of consensus about what it is that we would like to see as a board. I am not looking for action tonight, because I think we need some time to really let this marinate and figure out where we come down. But I did want to get the ball rolling, because there are a number of things that are impacted right now that I know I've already been asked, like, when's next year's calendar coming out? Well, this is one of the big ones that's kind of putting a hold on that. Also, some of the contracts, that's also a hold. I do have a draft calendar of what next year can look like, but I can't advance that until I really know where we, as a team, come down on some of these things. So if I could just kind of stop talking at this point and open up the door and hear where you are a little bit, I think that will kind of help gauge some of our next steps.
Yeah.
And a lot of other places too. I just think it would be nice to listen to
built into the tentative calendar that is developed right now.
That's great. I really like your recommendations. There's a small community within the Women's District. They're practicing Jews and they take Passover. It's a religious week, they take completely off. It might be something to take into consideration. Even if you do take some days or starting your maybe you could be kind of in that time frame so that their children don't necessarily miss it. Our spiritual side, I know the app of the campus. It has a list where you can kind of like put what type of absence was. Is it a religious absence? Is it sick? Whatever. I love that. That was an excellent addition to that. So they would then put a religious absence or whatever on it. But, you know, if there are some days that we can put flexible, perhaps we can take that into consideration.
Is there any way, we're looking at the budget, is there any way saving money somewhere? I mean, honestly, there's been years, the 1 year the school district did start after Labor Day, and my kids were young, and we struggled to get childcare these last 2 weeks. So, like, I do get that, and I'm very aware of it, you know, for our parents, but is there any way, like, with the buses, do we pay, and I'm sorry, I don't know if all this comes back, but, like, could we save money on busing for a couple days not going to school? And again, I do want to say, I want to make sure that just don't get paid because it's going to, you know, like a really, you know,
sure.
Maybe that is something we consider, but, you know, tied into a central partnership.
Yeah, so, I mean, if we're not having our students go 180 days, let's say we have them go 178, that would be two less days of transportation. It would be a cost savings at that point. I guess for me, I am looking at it a little bit more on the, right, trying to find that middle ground, right? When we create our calendars, there are a lot of, right, it was already mentioned over here, BCTC, that's one of those schools that we try to make sure we partner with because our students go there. We also have to keep in mind extracurricular schedules because, you know, if we're delaying the start of our day, which maybe is delaying the end of our day, maybe not, if they look at those hours, we need to make sure that when we have games scheduled, it also aligns when other schools have games scheduled. And you know, obviously there's a myriad of things in that realm. For me, I was thinking a little softer and easier. I think I was just thinking like, hey, maybe if there's like a day or two that's a traditional snow day where we have,
ooh,
you know, significant snow, maybe at the end of the year we just don't make one or two of those up. Right, I'm not saying a lot. I don't think we want to let that pendulum swing too far one way or the other. But maybe that's something that we want to consider.
So you have to set a number. This is how
right.
many snow days.
Yeah.
And once we get that many, we have to make one.
Right.
So I like that.
Some districts have built D-days.
So again, speaking transparently, I'm awarding anybody that is paying attention to our school board meeting at this point. Right now, it's not official, but if I were making a decision in a second based on the forecast, I would say that it looks like tomorrow will be a traditional snow day. But I absolutely take a look at what that end of the year calendar looks like. So I know I have one more day I really need to play with, because that will be Friday. And then anything more, like that's my last real snow day possibility that I have at this point. Because other than that, we start taking away more from not a large spring break, and then we start going into the week after, and nobody wants to be there. So, you know, this would give us some flexibility if our last day is already a Friday at the end of the week. Maybe a day or two is something we can say, like, you know, don't be a kid, we'll be all right, we'll pick up when you get back. But I don't know, that's my personal thought. I don't want to steer the conversation, because this is definitely a board level decision.
I think the app days are really frustrating. It's hard.
Yeah.
We have them, what, once a month? Or are you
approximately once a month.
And let's be real, nothing really happens when you have to. By the time you get it reorganized, sat down, it's time to. So they're pretty much, in my mind, useless.
Yeah, you know, a number of school districts are certainly starting to move away from the half days. I do think, as a parent, now my girls are kind of a little bit older, but when they were younger, that was tough to figure out. you know, both working parents, and how do you work that? So I think there's a transition to maybe a living half days if you're going to do an in-service day, which you have to do at some point. Make a full day, and they're honestly a little bit easier as a parent to figure out. So I think that's something that we can absolutely do.
Can we just talk about why we pick up Wednesdays?
I know.
Make it up because for whatever reason, no, it's a snow day. They get paid for it. It's already unwritten, man. There's always unwritten days. No one knows exactly how many days it is. I remember going to school going, I think it's five or whatever. Whatever that number, you know, and if you went over that number, then you had to make it up, which I think very, very seldomly happened. You know what I mean? What we call snow days as soon as it's in the weather next. You know, it's supposed to snow tomorrow. Oh, snow, we're off, and then we're off for 3 days fall. And it takes to clean the roads up, you know what I mean? Which is kind of ridiculous. That's just my personal opinion. So I guess a snow day, like you did perfectly, it was a snow day. The next day wasn't necessarily a snow day. So I guess those are the days you would have to make up. So that's, I mean, and then we talked about spring break, and then we worry about childcare, right? So in spring break, you have to worry about childcare. Most snow days, parents already know that you got to figure it out. You're not going to school. You might not even be able to go to work. You know what I mean? So that's all that I have to say.
Any other public comment?
Man, Bob hasn't been up in a minute.
I just have one question about is trust on hours. What does that mean? Is that hours in school or is that in particular classes? What is that 900 or 998 hours mean?
Sure, great question. That does not include your lunch time. It does not include transition time between classes. It is calculated based on your, let's use high school for example, their first period, how long is that period, the next period, how long is that, the next period, how long is that. Calculate just the instructional minutes, not from the drop-off and pick-up time, instructional minutes in each day.
Great.
Yep, you're welcome. Any other public comment on this?
So I have one additional question. So with the teacher contract and the 190 days, so what hypothetically would occur next year if we adjusted to account for this new rule? Is it that we would contract for only 180 days?
No, it would not be 180 days because the number of days that need teachers there needs to be greater than the number of days that we count for students there. So we can buy professional development, their mandated training, say, et cetera, et cetera. It would be, anyway, we're still in negotiations, so it could be anything. But theoretically, it could be anything from days or excuse for them, or those days are now in-service days, so they have to complete professional development training, and anything in between.
Okay. Any other public comment? Any questions from the board?
So it looks like for the preliminary budget, it's not final.
Thank you.
It's not final. There's 30,000, a lot of that perhaps we can figure out if there are any additional needs. But they have to be actively working for 190, I guess. We have to figure out if we even have like the enough money in the budget to cover for any possible structural needs when you're going to take that consideration, right?
So, I'm sorry, you're looking at the $30,000
on what? $30,000. So, it's 10 additional days, and the children aren't going to be present. I'm assuming it would be, as I said, we may have hired outside company to come in.
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
So, for those 10 additional days, could it be that those gave me a lot of those instructions? I just don't know if $30,000 would be a couple of times. You know what I mean?
It would.
All right, thank you.
public comment on any issues that someone wants to speak about.
Martino, 225 West Wells Drive. You know, the budget, judging by so many board members putting on their winter coats, paying too much money for air conditioning.
I agree. Yeah.
Seriously, it's cold in here. See what your workshop. Pros and cons. The pro, thank you. I think it's excellent that you're presenting this to the public and let them have input and get them involved. Cons, and this is my opinion, understand that, it's my opinion, but I still think you're doing it backwards as far as not a zero-based budget. Your last budget workshop is going to be about personnel. 60% of your budget is personnel, and that's what you're doing last. I don't see how that makes sense. Also, it sounds like you've already decided, well, we're going to have a tax increase. We don't know that we have to, and it's not going to be 5.3, but we're going to have something, because no tax increase is no good, even though you don't know that yet until you do that personnel part. And Kristen, I wish you would stop saying, please. Well, it's only $150 a year, or whatever. $150 a year times 20 years is $3,000, plus it's $150 this year, last year, next year, the year after that. It's not just $150, because it's compounding. And I wish you would all take that in consideration when you look at, well, it's only 2.3%, please. But I think the budget workshops are good for the community. Thank you.
Anyone else have any public comment on any issues that you'd like to bring up? Alright, seeing none. Can I have a motion for adjournment?
I'll make the first.